In de hal presenteren we een selectie van de werken van Center for Postnatural History. En Rich Pell heeft dat center opgericht. Hi Rich, how are you?
Hi Karen, good to see you.
Stand on this side. Mm-hmm. Can you explain us a little bit what the Center for Postnatural History is about?
Absolutely. The Center for Postnatural History is a public outreach center that's dedicated to documenting and exhibiting life forms that have been altered by people, intentionally altered. Mm-hmm. So these are genetically engineered life forms, they're selectively bred life forms, everything from the dawn of agriculture all the way up to transgenics.
So it's basically a natural history museum of the future looking back.
Of the post-natural.
That's okay, right. Perfect. Which samples did you bring for us?
We brought, for example, this is a mosquito that has been genetically engineered by a group of researchers at University of California, Irvine. Mm-hmm. And there's a number of universities involved in this project, but their intention is to create a mosquito that cannot carry malaria and thereby replace the natural existing population of mosquitoes and eliminate the problem of malaria for people.
So this is a solution against malaria using the same bugs that actually cause malaria?
That's the intention, yes.
Okay, great. And you made some postcards as well?
Yes, these are a part of our post-natural treasury set of cards for each organism that's in the collection. It has a photograph and then, you know, factual information on the back. These are good collectibles.
Great, perfect. You mentioned because the video is showing the spread of transgenic organisms in the state, right?
Yes, this is within the United States. This is later on in the video. But we have a map of the U.S. Based on permit applications that have to be filed when you release a genetically engineered organism. And so we have records of those, every genetically engineered organism that's been released since 1987 to present.
Okay. Okay. And you mentioned when we were discussing your installation here, you mentioned that there is some data available for spread in Europe as well?
Yes. There is information for each country in the EU, and we're working on a similar animation for that, and we hope to get it up and running soon.
Yeah, that's going to be a shocker for lots of people in Europe, because most people do think that there aren't any transgenic organisms.
It's not true.
Out, no? It's not true. And your future work is going to show that it's not true.
Yeah,
okay, great.
Absolutely.
Well, thanks so much.
Thank you.